McManus.
Well, in Luxor, St. Paddy's Day found its way to the weekend after all. Be good or be gone. Now, Margaret, swirl the shaker gently when you're making a Rob Roy. You don't want to bruise the vermouth. Or...
I know. Or the customers. All right. Tell them a story, Da. They're right for the listening.
Let's hear one, Jack. Yeah.
Well, as you could imagine, we've had our fair share of celebrated customers. One day, Al Flynn walks in here, and he was looking pretty gone. And as you know, I don't take too much to serving drunks. Well, he walks right up to the bar and said, I'll have a double vodka on the rocks. And I said, you're not going to get it from me. And I showed him the door. Then he said, who the hell are you, you fat little maggot? Give me my drink. And I said, all right, sir, right away. And I poured him one on the spot, on the house.
All right, tell him another, Da. He's got acres of them.
Well, if you're so inclined.
Yeah, let's hear another one. Yeah.
All right, then. There was this time Mr. Bart Lancaster came in, and he was having a few. Now, this was during the Vietnam War, and Mr. Lancaster chose to make an unpleasant remark about the American flag. And as you can imagine, that didn't sit too well with me. Well, I told him, not in here, you don't, and I showed him the door. My way or the highway? Then he said, hey, you, I'm Bart Lancaster. And I said, Bart Lancaster? I'm sorry, sir. I didn't realize you're right about this country. I tore down the flag and I trampled on it. Then he said, that's not good enough. And I begged for mercy. Please don't hurt me. I'm a weak man, I cried. Then some guy in the crowd called me a crybaby, and I showed him the door. Then he said, nice try, crybaby, but I'm with Mr. Lancaster. Now keep him coming, you bloated Irish freak.
Yeah. After that, Da tended to him as best he could, but they were hard to please. And sure enough, by 2 in the morning, they had him crawling on all fours with his pants around his ankles. And by night's end, he was soundly caned by the lot of them.
Hey, who's telling the story here?
Oh.
I was so beaten, I had to shut the place down for 2 weeks. And that's the only time this establishment's been closed in 76 years. Yeah.
History.
Oh, you bet there is. Tell them about Nelson Rockefeller.
Oh, I don't think they're interested in my meeting Governor Rockefeller.
Tell it.
All right, all right. It was election eve, 1964, and who waltzes in but Governor Rockefeller and his cronies, confident as can be. Well, a female patron was leaving the place, and Rockefeller just sits there all full of himself. Well, I walk over to him, and I say, I don't care for St. Patrick himself. When a lady gets up to leave, you rise. And he said, what did you say to me? And I said, nothing. I didn't say anything. And he said, no, I heard what you said. And I said, I'm sorry, I didn't. And he said, listen, fat man, I don't like the sound of your voice. I don't want to hear another word out of you for the rest of the evening. Not one word. And sure enough, you didn't hear a peep out of me for the rest of the night.
People ordering drinks, Da say nothing.
I even kept quiet long after because I was afraid he might have spoils. that was Governor Rockefeller.
Tell us about some of these pictures on the wall.
Yeah. Oh, here's a good one.
Ah, yes. There it is, me over here on all fours again. And the man kicking me in the behind is none other than Mr. Clark Gable. Woo. Ah, now that's Mr. Branch Rickey from the Brooklyn Dodgers. I'm not in the photo because he forced me to take my clothes off and dance around. And that's the only time there's been nude dancing in this establishment, I can tell you. This is a good one here. This looks like a bullseye, but the man throwing the darts is none other than...
Spin the tail and pour you a nail when you go to Jack McManus.